I mean, I personally don't see it as a controversial call. I've already seen the replay, and one girl fouled me in my face, and one girl fouled me on my arm. So at that point, you can't do anything else.
Did you see when DiJonai drove the ball from where you were standing?
What did you see?
I was surprised they didn't call a foul.
Then write it like that. You don't need a quote from me. I've got steel shots and video from two angles. One kid hits her in the face, and one kid hits her on the elbow.
Watching it again, LeBron James was watching. Come on, man. That was a foul. He went on to say it was a great game in addition to that. 0.8 seconds left. Baylor, last chance. Down two. Have to go the length of the court. Long inbound intercepted as time expires. And that's how UConn defeats Baylor. 69-67. UConn back to the Final Four. Wow, what a game this was. The game turned following the injury to Baylor's all-conference guard, Dede Richard, late in the third. The Bears shot just 31% the rest of the way without the Big 12's leader in assists. And UConn went on a 19-zip run shortly after the injury. The Huskies had been down 10 at the time, their largest deficit of the tournament. But Geno and UConn moving on. They sweated this one out.
This was harder than winning some of the national championship games that we've won. Without question. Without question. This game was tougher than a handful of national championship games or any Final Four game that you want to mention. So, yeah, winning this game, you know, given how it played out, you know, getting down 10, that's an amazing accomplishment by these young kids.
Getting a tough win like that against one of the best teams in the country, it's so rewarding just to hear that final buzzer go off and you win and you make it to the Final Four. And it's really unexplainable, the feeling that you really get from it. It's like a dream come true.
The whole story of the game is Dede Richards goes down and the whole momentum shifted, okay? So you think at that point your team could fold their tent. You got a freshman that you're putting in there that, you know, hadn't been on this big stage. And, you know, I'm sure she was nervous, and we got to build her up and make her feel good. But I thought, you know, all you can do is coach to the bitter end and give yourself an opportunity. And boys and girls, it'd have been fun to see DiJonai to go to that foul line right there.
Wow, consider everything that happened in that game. Even better to have Carolyn Peck with us here on SportsCenter to break it all down. And we got to start at the end, Carolyn. You know what everyone's been talking about, the last play. And I thought this was interesting. Even UConn legend Swin Cash thought it was a foul. Check out her tweet, quote, "I love my Huskies, but yeah, they missed that foul. Woo cha." Well, what was your take on what happened on that non-call?
Well, I think that there was a foul.
Okay.
And it happened even before DiJonai went into her shot. But earlier in the game, Paige Bueckers also got knocked to the floor. This was a physical game. But in watching this play, DiJonai Carrington, you see right there, Olivia Nelson-Adota had her by the arm, and then, right there. And then when she goes into her shooting motion, Aaliyah Edwards is not vertical. She is not straight up. But that wasn't the first time fouls happened in that game.
Yeah.
It was a very physical ball game. And you can look at it and say that play or the previous one, when you also have opportunities at the free throw line, you have an opportunity when you only lose a game by two.
All right, well, let's talk about the other significant moment in this game. That was that 19-0 run by UConn. They were down 10 to go up 9 the first 3 minutes of the first fourth quarter. What changed during that time that allowed the Huskies to even do that?
Well, you got to understand, to start the season, Baylor had moved Dede Richards to the point guard spot because they really didn't have a true point guard.
Mm-hmm.
So when she went out with 2 minutes and 37 seconds left in that third quarter going down, there was no leadership. There was not a brainchild on the floor. And then turnovers started happening for Baylor.
Mm-hmm.
And once the turnovers happened, confidence started coming for the UConn Huskies. And that's when the shots started falling. That's when this young team now was like, the door's open.
Yeah.
I could go to the Final Four, and they took full advantage of it.
All right, so now UConn moves on to face Arizona in the Final Four.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.